You all have heard about instrument formula by G.V. Black in Operative Dentistry. Yet there may be many confusing points on it. There are two types of formula, 3-number formula and 4-number formula. So before that, you need to know the basic parts of the instrument. This part is known as the blade, shank and handle. This is a standard enamel hatchet which we see in the operative dentistry. So this instrument is slightly different from what you see here. What is different here? This part, that is the cutting edge, is curved when compared to the normal enamel hatchet. It is a gingival marginal trimmer or GMT. So this instrument has a 3-number formula, whereas this has a 4-number formula. What differs in them? The cutting edge is perpendicular to the long axis of the blade in this instrument, whereas it is not perpendicular in this instrument. That is the difference. When the cutting edge is perpendicular to the long axis of the blade, then you only have 3 numbers in the instrument formula. So the 3-numbered formula for the first example, first number denotes the width in 10th of the millimeter. That is, if the first number is 15, then the width will be 1.5 mm. Then second number is the length of the blade, that is denoted by this blue line, length of the blade in millimeters. If the second number is 7, then the length of the blade is 7 mm. The third number is the blade angle relative to the long axis of the blade. Okay, this is the long axis of the instrument and this is the long axis of the blade. So the angle relative to both, this angle will be the blade angle. The 4-number instrument formula differs in that it has a new second number. The 3rd number will become the length of the blade and the 4th number will be the blade angle. So the new number is inserted in the second position. You have to remember this. Remember that the 4th number is always the blade angle. So the new number will come in the second position. What is this cutting edge angle? It is again the long axis of the instrument. As you could see here, this is the long axis of the cutting edge. And the angle which is formed between the long axis of the instrument to the long axis of the cutting blade. This angle is known as cutting edge angle. And in G.V. Black's formula, they do not use the standard for number of, like you use a 360 degree circle, right? They use a 100 degree circle. It is known as the centigrade circle. Therefore, a 90 degree doesn't mean what you see in everyday life. A 90 degree is a perpendicular angle, right? But G.V. Black's centigrade circle, this total circle's degree equals 100 degrees. Therefore, this angle will be somewhat nearing 90. Remember, 360 degree is equal to 100 degree in a centigrade circle. And G.V. Black uses centigrade circle. Therefore, this angle, which is almost 360, will be nearing 100 in G.V. Black's formula. And therefore, this angle will be somewhat nearing 90. Okay, this, if it forms a complete circle, then it is 100. Here it is nearing 90, somewhat between 80 to 90. And similarly, the blade angle that we saw, this angle will be somewhat less than 50. Okay, the straight line will be 50. So this angle will be less than 50. So this is just an extra information which you need to know. They do not follow the standard 360 degree circle, they follow a 100 degree circle, which means 180 degrees in day-to-day life is equal to 50 degree in the centigrade circle, and 360 degree in day-to-day life equals to 100 degrees in the centigrade circle. Therefore, you have to remember that according to this circle, if it is less than 50 degree, it is the blade angle. If it is more than 50 degree, it means the cutting edge angle. It is a common norm that usually the blade angle will be less than 50 degrees. And cutting edge angle will be more than 50 degree. With that differentiation, you can always remember the difference between the blade angle and the cutting edge angle. This is an example of a 4-number and a 3-numbered formula. So let me check whether you remember. What is this? What does this denote? This is the width. The first number is the width of the instrument in 10th of millimeter. Therefore, it is 1.5 mm. You have to keep a decimal point here if it is called as 10th of a millimeter. And come to the third number. This is the length of the blade, 8 mm. This is the blade angle, 12 degree according to a centigrade circle. Okay. So this second number will be the cutting edge angle, which is as I showed you right in the previous thing. It is almost 100, right? So here 95 degree. Okay. And this is an example of a three number formula. The width of the blade, that is 1 mm here, the length of the blade and the blade angle. So I hope I have cleared your doubts. If you have further doubts, kindly let me know in the comments. I will clear that also. Thank you.